And welcome back, everyone. Make sure you hit that like button, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Hope everyone's enjoying this series. Let's go play some Fallout New Vegas, Honest Hearts.
No, thanks.
Thank you.
This is taking too long. We can't let salt upon wounds escape. I'm going to find a way around. God willing, we will finish this together.
Gut.
We warned you at Syracuse, and you persisted. You took advantage of us at New Canaan to drive us out. And like the dogs of Caesar you are, you followed us to Zion. And now you stand on holy ground, a temple to God's glory on Earth. The only use for an animal in our temple is sacrifice. Kale Wachane Conserva O. You understand me, don't you? Don't you?
Outman. Kunaman, mad. He kill all white legs. You talk. You stop. Him hear you. You talk.
Don't listen to this thing. His cries are those of a mad beast caught in a thicket. He gave no mercy to my family, and I will give none to his. He has a debt to pay for what he's done, and I've come to collect. And so he's chosen to cower in the water like a dumb animal. I want to take from them what they took from me, from my family. In this life, I want them to suffer. I want all of them to die in fear and pain. I want to have my revenge against him, against Caesar. I want to call it my own, to make my anger God's anger, to justify the things I've done. Sometimes I tell myself that these wildfires never stop burning, but I'm the one who starts them, not God, not them. I can always see it in my mind. The warmth and the heat. It will always be a part of me. But not today. Go. Get out of here. Go back. Back to the Great Salt Lake. That's it. It's finished. Thank you for staying. I couldn't have done this on my own. Let's go find Daniel. Tomorrow we'll be here soon. And there is much to do.
So it was that the conflict between the New Canaanites and the White Legs was finally resolved. The courier's involvement had tipped the scale, shifting the fragile balance of power.
Demoralized by the Dead Horse and Sorrow's attack the courier and Joshua Graham led against them, the White Legs retreated to Great Salt Lake. Their days were numbered. Word soon reached the 80s tribe that the White Legs' spirit was broken. Their war chief, a dim shadow of his former self. By year's end, the 80s would overrun the White Legs' camps, scattering the tribe to the winds and claiming the Great Salt Lake for its own.
The Sorrows fought beside Joshua Graham and the Dead Horses, eradicating the threat the White Legs posed to Zion. Seeing the courier convince Joshua Graham to spare Salt Upon Wounds, the Sorrows learned that retribution could be tempered by mercy. Though he despaired at the Sorrows' loss of innocence, Daniel took some small consolation in the courier's lesson and prayed it would take root.
Having helped eradicate the White Legs from Zion, the Dead Horses returned to Dead Horse Point in triumph. They remained neutral toward the Sorrows, but as years went on, there were periods of competitive friction, even violence between the tribes. The New Canaanites, Daniel especially, intervened regularly as mediators, but found it difficult to reconcile the tribes' conflicts.
The defeat of the White Legs and Zion marked a turning point in the fortunes of the Happy Trails Caravan Company. Every 2 months, the caravan met with the new Canaanites in Zion Valley to trade. Happy trails soon returned to prosperity. The vigilance of the Sorrows and Dead Horses in defending southwestern Utah, initially startling to Happy Trails caravans, soon proved a blessing. The tribes united against the 80s, driving them back from Highway 50, and thus opening yet another trading route for Happy Trails caravans.
The threat of the White Legs ended. Joshua Graham helped the Sorrows and Dead Horses tend to their fallen comrades and secure Zion. The courier's words had stayed Joshua's wrath in his darkest hour, and in sparing Salt Upon Wounds, he was changed. While he continued to advocate militant opposition to the enemies of New Canaan, he sometimes showed quarter to those who crossed his family. Eventually, this new spirit would diminish the myth of the burned man in distant lands, a small price for the peace it brought to Joshua Graham.
For years after the defeat of the White Legs, Daniel did his best to minister to the Sorrows' spiritual needs. Try as he might, he could not hold back the tribe's increasing militancy and reverence of Joshua Graham. Demoralized, he returned to his family and Dead Horse Point. His failures haunted him for the rest of his days.
And with that, the courier walked out of the history of the tribes of Zion and back to the gathering storm of the Mojave Wasteland.
And that's the end of this series for the Fallout New Vegas Honest Hearts DLC. Hope everyone enjoyed this series. Make sure you hit the like button, make sure you subscribe button. I'm going to go ahead, get me out of this valley, go ahead and put stuff away, sell stuff off, and get ready to continue doing some more of these DLCs and get them done, and then we can start focusing on the other end quests. Anyways, I'll see you again soon.